Whenever I leave my home, I have this weird problem. My garage door is controlled through Home Assistant, so if I want to open and close the door, I can just bring up the app and then scroll down a little bit, and then you can see the door behind me opens automatically. But the problem with that is, when I'm in this grey zone of leaving the house and I'm halfway down the hill and I want to close the door, my phone can't reach. So I have to make sure that I'm connected to Tailscale so that I can actually reach the reverse proxy that is the front door, so to speak, of my Home Assistant instance. So in order to do that, I've written a very, very basic iOS shortcut that makes sure I'm connected to the right tailnet and then toggles the switch to close the garage door. So that's what we're going to cover today, is a very basic overview of how to use Tailscale with iOS shortcuts. Right, so in essence, it's a really straightforward process. We want to make sure we've got a Tailscale account. We want to make sure we've got, in my case, a Home Assistant instance ready. Beyond that, you don't need an awful lot else. So in the iOS Shortcuts app, and I think all of this stuff is available on older versions of iOS 2, but I'm using iOS 26 here. So if you're on an old version, you might just want to make sure you upgrade, but I don't think there's anything specific to iOS 26 here. So yeah, what we want to do is go up to the top right-hand corner where it says New Shortcut, click on the little plus button, and then search for the actions under Tailscale. You can see there are a bunch of actions available here, but the one I want to make sure I do first of all is switch account, and I'm going to select alexktz@gmail.com because that's the tailnet that my Home Assistant instance lives inside of. The next thing I want to do is make sure I'm actually connected to that tailnet. Now, I'm not sure if this is totally necessary because I think these two steps might possibly be redundant, but belt and braces, it doesn't really harm anything. Now, one thing I want to make sure that we also do is turn off this show when run, because if we don't do that, then it will give me a notification and kind of get in the way of the automation actually running. And then finally, I'm just going to go into the Home Assistant option here and do control switch. I'm going to search for the switch of car, Sonoff SV garage car, and then toggle, and that's it. And when I press this now, you should see that my phone connects to the tailnet automatically and the garage door is now opening behind us. So the use case for this, I see, like, iOS shortcuts are very powerful and you can trigger them based on a lot of different conditions, things like SSIDs changing, so when you get to the office you could make sure you're automatically connecting to your work tailnet, for example, or whenever you get home, make sure you turn off Tailscale or leave it turned on, whatever. I don't know, I'm not going to judge. But the iOS shortcuts gives you a lot of options and a lot of permutations that you can do with triggers and automations and that kind of thing. And this really is just scratching the surface, but this is something I find incredibly, incredibly useful on the daily basis. So we've got this thing called control switch. We can now rename this to garage car. Okay, I'm going to change the icon. I'm going to choose a car, sure, make it blue because that's the color of this car. And then under the information option here, the little eye icon down here, there are a couple of things. So we can show it on our Apple Watch if we want to. That could be handy. We can also show it in the share sheet, or, and this one's more useful for me, we can add it to the home screen. So if we do this and select this button, you can now see that I can just run this shortcut directly from my iPhone's home screen, and I can hear it, you probably can't. You'll see the garage door is now closing just by pressing that one button. And the beauty of this is that I don't necessarily need to be on my home Wi-Fi for this to work anymore. I can be in that Wi-Fi twilight zone, the gray zone, where my phone hasn't quite realized what's going on yet. The other thing we can do is come into the iOS, what's it called, control center, and we can actually add a control. So if we go to shortcuts, we can say run a shortcut, and I can now choose from here the garage car shortcut. And I have now in my control center swipeable, you know, driving safety and all that. You know, I want to make sure, you know, you use drink Tailscale responsibly and all that good stuff. But I can now trigger, you can see the garage door from my control center, so I don't need to take up a precious slot on my app home screen, my iPhone home screen. So that's pretty much just scratching the surface of what's possible using iOS shortcuts and Tailscale. And I hope you find it useful. Let me know in the comments down below what you're using it for. In fact, you can take it one step further and go and join our Discord server at discord.gg/tailscale and tell us all about what you're using iOS shortcuts for with Tailscale. As always, thank you so much for watching. And until next time, I've been Alex from Tailscale.